Good morning, my dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to solve the remaining problems from exercise 3B. Okay. See here. Yes. Till yesterday, we have learned the problems till 18. Okay. So today we will see 19, 20, 21, and 22. Pay attention very carefully. See, problem number 19 is what least number must be added to 594. To make the sum a perfect square. Okay, problem number 19. In the 500, given number is 594. And in this 594, which least number must be added? Which least number must be added so that we will get a perfect square? That means what you know? This 594, it is not the perfect square. So, when we add that least number, that smallest number in this 594, we will get a perfect square. So, first, what we need to do, we have to find that which is the smaller perfect square than 594. Okay. So, once we get that, we can get that by using our long division method. Okay. See here first. By long division method, since it is not perfect square, but we will come to know whether which is the smaller perfect square than this 594. So as usual, do this, form groups, okay? Understood. Now in the first group there is 5. So which is the smaller perfect square than 5? 4. 4, okay? And 4, you know, 4 is square of 2. So 2 2's are 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. Then second group, take down 194, and 2 2's are 4 here. Got it? Now here we have to take digits out of 0 to 9. Now see which digit will be occur here. See how to find the digits here in this 3, out of this 3 digit number. Number formed by first 2 digits is 19, and you know when we divide 19 by 4, what quotient do we get? 4 4s are 16, correct? So 4 will come here, 4 4s are 16, so 4 will come here and here. Now let us check, 4 4s are 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carried, 4 4s are 16 and 1, 17, okay? Subtract this. 4 minus 6 not possible. So 40 minus 6 is 8. 9 minus 8 is 1. 1 minus 1 0. Okay, 18. So 18 is remainder here. Now we don't have to do anything with the remainder. Here we have to find which least number will be added to 594 to get the perfect square. Now by this, what we have come to know? 594 is greater than the square of 24. See, square of 24 is less than 594. That is what the smaller perfect square than 594 is the square of 24. That means the nearest greater perfect square number than 94 will be square of 25, right? Means this number 594 appear or comes between these two perfect squares, square of 24 and square of 25. Now we have to add in this number, in 594 we have to add the least number or add any least number so that it will become perfect square. So it will become perfect square after adding this, it will become the square of 25, right? So see here, to find that what we need to do, you know, 25 square minus 594. To find that least number, what we have to do from the square of 25, we have to subtract 594. And you know what is square of 25? 625 minus 594, which is equal to 5 minus 4, 1, 12 minus 9 3, okay, so 31. And here 6 minus 6 0, 31, okay. So 31 is the least number which when we add in 594, we will get next perfect square, which is square of 25. That is C, 594. In this 594, when we add 31, we will get 625. And 625 is the square of 25. Understood? Now you will think that why we have done this long division method. This we have done to determine that 590, which is the smaller perfect square than 594. So that we will decide that which is the nearest perfect square which is greater than 594. Okay? Because 594 we have to convert into the perfect square by adding the least number. But we must know which is the nearest perfect square greater than 594. That's why we have done this, and we come to know that the square of 24 is smaller than 594. So obviously the bigger perfect square or greater perfect square than 594, it is the square of 25. Okay, next number. That's why we have done this. So whenever we have to solve such problems where we have to find the least number which will be added in the given number to find the perfect square, we have to go by this way. Understood? Question number 9, 20 is also same like this. You have to do same. First, find by long division method, find that which is the nearest perfect square than the given number. So obviously you will come to know that which is nearest greater than the given number, and then do the subtraction. Okay. Then see question number 21. Question number 21. Find the least number of 6 digits which is a perfect square. Find the least number of 6 digits which is a perfect square. So here first write which is the least 6 digit number. Which is the least 6 digit number, smallest 6 digit number is 10000. That is 1 lakh, okay? 1 lakh is the smallest 6 digit number. But this is not a perfect square because there are odd number of zeros. Okay, this is not the perfect square. So, to find the least 6 digit perfect square number, what we have to do? In this 1 lakh, we have to add least number, same like this now. Okay, because why we cannot subtract, because if you subtract anything to find the perfect square, that number which you will get, it will be less than, it will be 5 digit number, right? So it will get 5 digit number, we want least 6 digit, that's why in this least 6 digit number, we need to add any number to get the least perfect square which is 6 digit, okay? So same procedure we have to do here. First, make sure that which is the this 1 lakh, which is the smaller perfect square than 1 lakh, so that once you decide by this method which is the smaller perfect square than 1 lakh, then automatically you will get which is the nearest or which is the greater perfect square than the 1 lakh. Okay, so let us write here 1 lakh. Done. Now make the groups from back side. Fine. Now, in the first group there is 10, okay, so smaller perfect square than 10 is 9, and it is square of 3. 10 minus 9 is 1. Take this down, become 100, 3 2s are 6. Okay, now in the 100, it is 3 digit number, which digit should appear here? Which digit should appear here to get the smaller number than 100, because one more group is there, okay? So see here, 6, the number formed by first two digits is 10, okay? And if you divide 10 by 6, you will get quotient 1, because 6, 1 is 6. So here 1 right, and here also. 61, 1 is 61. Remain, 10 minus 1, 9. And 10 minus 7 is 3. 39. After that, take this group down 0, 0. 31 twos are 62. Now here we have to take the digit, right? And take that digit or to engage that digit, what we need to do? Here in the dividend box, there are 4 digit numbers. So number found by first 3 digit is 390. So divide it by 62. So 62 exact. 6 2s are 12, 6 6 are 36 and 1 37. Correct. 6 are 372. Okay? This is the nearest smaller number. Sorry. 6. Okay, so right here 6 and here 6. Now 626 multiply by 6. What we are getting? 6 6 are 36, 3 will be carried, 6 2 are 12 plus 3 15, 5 will come down, 1 will be carried, 6 is a 36 and 1 37. Sorry. 3756. 3756. Okay. Subtract this. 10 minus 6, 4. 10 minus 6, 4 again. 9 minus 8. 1, 3 minus 3, 0. 144 is the remainder. Okay. Now, by this, we come to know that, this 1 lakh, you know, 1 lakh, which is smallest 6 digit number, is greater than the square of 360. Okay, that means the nearest. The nearest number which is greater than 1 lakh will be the square of perfect square, which is square of 370. Okay? Understood. So, here we to find that least number from the square of 370, we need to subtract 1 lakh. Okay? So, what is square of 370? How to find? 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 9 plus 1 10. So 1 2, this is the square of 370. That is 1,489. From this number, when you subtract 1 lakh, you will get that least number, which we need to add in 1 lakh to get this perfect square. So what is that number? Obviously 489. Okay. So 489 is that least number which we need to add in the smallest 6-digit number to get the least 6-digit perfect square number. Okay, what we have done, see carefully. Same method which we have done there, same method we have applied. Okay. This is question number 21. Now see question number 22. Question number 22 is, a general arranges his soldiers in rows to form a perfect square. Okay? To form a perfect square. He has to arrange his soldiers in such a way that the arrangement will be like a perfect square. Square shape. He finds that doing so, 60 soldiers are left out. So when he arranges his soldiers in a square shape, 60 soldiers are left out. If the total number of soldiers are 8,341, find the numbers of soldiers in each row. So he has total soldiers How many total soldiers he has in his platoon? 8,341. 8,341. Okay, these soldiers he has to arrange in square shape. Correct? Means square shape means in row and in column there should be same number of soldiers to arrange in the square shape. So, what is the question? See here. Find the number of soldiers in each row. Find the number of soldiers in each row means when we arrange that out of these soldiers, when we arrange the soldiers in square shape, out of these 60 soldiers remain back. So, what is the number of soldiers in each row or each column? That we have to find. Such example we have done before. Same it is. Find the square root. As this is not the perfect square because when we arrange these soldiers in square shape, 60 soldiers remain back. That means this is not the perfect square. Okay. So let us find first square root of this. That means square root of the smaller perfect square than this. You know, make the groups first. 83 in the first group. The smaller perfect square than 83 is 81, right? And it is square of 9. So 9 9s are 81. Remain 2. 41 take down. 9 2s are 18. Now, which digit will come here? This is 3 digit number. So take number from the first 2 digits. It is 24. 18 1s are 18. Which is the quotient? 18 1s are 18. Okay. So 181 ones are 181. Yeah, 0. 14 minus 8 is 6. Yeah, 0. 60. See, when we found square root of this, okay, we got here in the quotient, we got 91 and here remainder is 60. That means 60 soldiers remain. Okay. So how many soldiers were there in each row? 91. Understood, 91 soldiers were there in each row because the square of 91 is when you subtract 60 from this, you will get square number of 91. So, this much soldiers were used. 8341 minus 60, this much soldiers were used to form that square shape. Okay, that is nothing but square of 91. So, in each row and each column, there were 91 soldiers. So, 91 into 91. Okay. So there were 91 soldiers in each row. Understood? So these are the three word problems which you have learned today. 20th problem you have to solve by yourself. Okay, so now pause this video, write these three problems in your notebook. After that, you will see remaining two examples which are higher order thinking skill. Okay? See now here problem number or question number 23, their thoughts question. See here, under root of 10 plus under root of 25 plus under root 108 plus under root 154 plus under root 225. So see this, how to solve this type of example. It's not so difficult. Pay attention carefully. First, find the square root of innermost number or innermost square root. See here, this is the innermost square root, and in that there is 225, and you know 225 is the square root of 15. Okay, so at this place we will write 15, but before that remaining write as it is. Plus 154 here, plus what is square root of 225? 15. Okay, so that instead of square root of 225, write 50. Okay, now after that, do this addition. What it will be? 154 plus 15, 169. Okay, here now see here also now there are four square roots we will solve first or we will find value of innermost square root so that is square root of 169 and you know 169 is also perfect square okay plus what is square root of 169 yes 169 is the square of 13 that's why its square root is 13 see how it is deducting one by one now three square roots remain It's 11. Sorry. Now two square roots remain. So now see plus 25 plus 11, 36. 10 plus square root of 36 is 6. And 10 plus 6, 16. Square root of 16, 4. Understood? Square root of 16, 4. Next, question number 24. Under root 1191.16 plus 70 into under root 129.96. So as usual, first we will find the square root of innermost number. Till that, remaining we will write as it is. 70 into. Between 70 and this square root, there is multiplication sign, okay, into 129.96. Now 129.96, it is square number of, what is the square root of this, that we have to find. So let us do by, you do here of work, by this method we can find it, see. Since it is decimal number, what to do, you know, do this way. Okay, here first group is 1, the perfect square which is equal to or less than 1 is 1 itself, 1 minus 1 0, take 29 down, 1 2's are 2, 1 2's are 2, double of this one is 2, now see this is actually 2 digit number in that first number formed by 1 digit is 2, if you divide this 2 by 2 you will get 1, so 2 1's are 21 ones are 21. Okay. Here remain 9 minus 1 remain 8. Now this group we are going to take down. Before that there is decimal point. So put your decimal point. Okay. 11 twos are right here 22. Now 89 divided by 22. 22 fours are 88. Okay. So right here 4. Okay. Sorry. Now 4 4s are 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carried, 4 2s are 8 and 1, 9, 4 2s are 8 and 1, sorry 4 2s are 8, okay, subtract, 0. That means the square root of 129.96 is nothing but 11.4. Okay, this was rough work, now if you write that, do this rough work, okay. Now, under root 1191.16 plus 70 into 11.4. So 7 4s are 28, 0 right here already. 7 4s are 28, 2 carry, 7 on the 7, 2, 9, 7 on the 7. Here decimal point, that is 798. Okay, so 0.0, so you can cut that. Done. So now add this 1191.16 plus 798.00. So here after point we will get 16 only. 1 plus 8, 9. 9 plus 9 18, 8 will come down, 1 will be carried. 7 plus 1 8 and 1 9 and this 1. So it's 1989.16. Okay. Now again you need to find the square root of this number. Okay. 19, 16, right? 4, 4 is a 16. Remain 3, take 8, 9 down, 4, 2 is a 8, 38 is there, 8, 4 is a 32, 4 is a 16, 4, 8 is a 32 and 1, 33. 9 minus 6, 3, 8 minus 3, 5, 0. Okay? Put your decimal point, take 16 down. 44 2s are 88. 44 2s are 88. Now, here see 531 divided by 88. 531 divided by 88. So, we can guess 88 into 4s are 32, 2 will come down, 3 will be carried, 4 is a 32 and 3, 35. Let us check by 6. 6 is a 48, 6 is a 48 and 4, 52, 528, yes, 6 are. So let us take 6 here. Now see 886 into this 6. 6 6 are 36, 3 carats, 8 6 are 48 and 3 51, 5 carat, 8 6 are 48 and 5, 53, 5316. Getting? 5316, exactly. That means 6 is correct, so 0. That means square root of 1989.16 is nothing but 44.6. 44.6. So in this way you have to solve such higher order means in questions. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt regarding this, we can discuss during problem solving. So thank you and have a good day.